Let's talk about evolution, shall we? And hello. People think that evolution is something that will happen in the future, that now we humans, we live, we go on with our lives, and we don't suspect in many cases that we can experience it already. And my message to you is that yes, it's possible, it's doable, it's happening, and I have a ticket. So what am I talking about? In previous steps, we as a species, we were concentrated on survival. So our goal was to gather as much knowledge as possible. And as a result, we have inbuilt generational structures in our consciousness. And just to name a few, it's profit, it's duty, and it's sacrifice. These are just a few. We've learned how to be successful. We've learned how world works on the physical level, but we still crave that bigness. Each of us living this seemingly great lives or not great lives for those who is not happy, and wondering what is it for. And this is where the interesting part begins. I've read the other day, someone spiritual said this interesting phrase. It said, we are not humans reaching out to God. We are God experiencing being human. It's perfect. One of my favorite thinkers of our century, Yuval Harari, he has this amazing book, Homo Deus. And that is exactly how I see evolution. Homo Deus, it's human dash God. And think about this, like we are souls on this planet experiencing through our exclusively powerful bodies, sensual, with all the receptors, we experience this life, and each of us has some pre-built information, pre-built knowledge. Think about it as specialists. Each of us has some kind of zest, and through life we reveal and sharpen our skills, our specialties. And when you think about evolution, when you get rid of this survival predicament, you realize that the goal transforms from survival into expressing this specialty of yours, which goes back to this individuality. We live in times when it's so crucial for us not to lose this identity of ours, even though it's one of the structures of consciousness. Wherever you look, it all talks about the same thing. Religion talks about unconditional love and acceptance. Esoteric people talk about controlling reality. And transforming the world around you, and peace on earth, peace with everything, among everything. And science talk about quantum particles. So everything around can be broken down to a quantum level. The main idea behind all of this is that we are the whole, and we came here with our specialties to be discovered and to be expressed without losing identity. So how do we get there? One might ask. It should be obvious that unconditional love and being part of everything is impossible with the old structures in our consciousness, duty or sacrifice as example. Therefore, to get to that point, it's necessary to clear your mind, your consciousness, and your body on a physical level, neuron connections. It's necessary to clear all of that as outdated version of the software such, I'm talking of consciousness. And this is what exactly my software in the air, my technology, which I called algoriswo, algorithm subjective world. That's exactly what it's for. To make it short and not get into details about science behind it, it's designed to clear your mind out of the outdated information, outdated structures of consciousness, in order to see the life from another perspective, from another paradigm, from the position I am the cause, observer effect in quantum physics. There are two questions to be asked. One of them is whether you want to go further, because it's easier to live the way it is now in survival mode. Generations lived like this. They died, but it works, kind of. And so what that you don't, that you wouldn't know what unconditional love is? Big deal, right? And second question is whether you want to let go of old way of living, because it might be easier to blame someone else than to be in charge of your own life fully. Fully, because gods don't ask anyone else, they take care of what's in front of them. Because the beauty of this all is that the world really has just one word, one answer to everything, and that answer is yes. So whatever you want happens. But when you live in a survival mode, you kind of hope, and you often reach, you get what you want, but it takes so much work and so much time. At 100 years old, you look back into your life and you already kind of know that, yeah, I should have done that, I should have spent more time there, but it's too late. You're 100, your life is over almost. Unless you're lucky. But who wants to live in an old body with when you can't hear, when you are at risk of disease, etc., etc.? And like this, you don't have to wait. You can change everything. It takes time sometimes, because old structures are very sturdy. It's the fundament of everything that's around you. You can't just remove the stud. You have to replace it with something, alternative that will make you happy, make you more creative, make you express yourself freely, and not be afraid of who you are, just do it. You have to find structures to replace what's irrelevant now, and that takes time sometimes, but it's not years. You don't have to wait 100 years. In my case, I've been rewiring my brain, as I say, for 2 years. It's been 2 years exactly. And this algoritmo that I've created, this is just an example of what is possible. Software in the air, literally. And I've done it. It works. And I see. It's incredible. And you tell it to a normal person, and person will say, cuckoo, cuckoo. But I don't care, because I know that this is amazing. When you care what others say, you are in a survival mode. But when you freely express yourself, when you shamelessly just go for it, go for life at every moment, here and now, as spiritual people say, not thinking, not being tied to past or future, but now. I will do it now, and then I'll see how it goes further, and I deal with it if it happens, whatever I'm afraid of. And even better, I will look into that beforehand and clear it so that it's not even going to happen. because it's not in consciousness. It's not part of structure anymore. This is how it works. And that's what the question for you is. Do you want to find what your specialty is? What your talents are? Do you want to know what love is? What unleashed creativeness, geniusness, enlightenment, wherever you put your own words? Do you want to find what you are here for and who you are? If yes, contact me. The ticket will be yours, but you already have it.